Today, on Be Something Wonderful, how to claim divine will as your own. This is big. I am your host, Tom Caron, and this is the Be Something Wonderful studio of Higher Consciousness, where we help you level up and become the best version of yourself. Welcome back, creators, and Happy New Year. Well, I got an email from a subscriber who said, Tom, so here's what's been happening. I've been really focused on my desire, but I've been getting obsessed with it, looking for it, trying really hard. But then I would let go, just let it completely go, thinking then it will manifest. But it still hasn't manifested. So I really don't know what to do. I know I'm not supposed to try hard and really work at it and be obsessed with it. But on the other hand, if I let go, it still doesn't come. Well, guys, we're going to unpack this today and more. Here's what I want to say, and I've said this before, but never the way I'm going to say it today, here on New Year's Day. Remember, when you're desiring something, that's God desiring through you. That's God wanting what you want through you. This is powerful. So it's not about giving up your will to desire it or to want it. It's about giving up your 3D will and letting the divine will, letting that higher will take over. The will of your higher being, the will of that Christ within you. Yeah? So let's unpack this a little bit more. And let's go to the greatest metaphysical book of all time was the Bible, right? And the greatest metaphysical teacher of all time was Jesus. Let's unpack some of this. This is what Jesus said. Who is the one who touched me? Now, this is when Jesus was going through the crowd, right, with his disciples, and he was going to a healing, right? He was gonna heal a little girl who was dying or resurrect her. And this is when another woman touched him, touched his garment, touched his cloak while he was in a crowd. Imagine Jesus now being surrounded by hundreds of people. And then this is what Peter said. Master, the people are crowding and pressing in on you. Hundreds of people. Imagine Jesus going through a crowd with hundreds of people. Yet one person dared to deliberately touch his cloak. Hear this, right? And then Jesus said, well, and listen to the wording here. It's quite remarkable. Someone did touch me. This is what Jesus said. For sure, right? You say, for sure, someone did touch me, for I was aware that power had gone out of me. Wow, hear this. I was aware that power had gone out of me. What's that second? This woman who touched him, this woman was sick, right? She was hemorrhaging. And she recognized Jesus, accepted it, and received that power when she touched the garment. Out of hundreds of people that were probably touching elbows with Jesus, right? She was the only one who recognized that higher consciousness, who recognized that power. Remember, Jesus represents your consciousness, represents your power. So she recognized that was the power within her, right? She healed herself through that Christ within her, through that power, right? She dared to touch that consciousness. She dared to rise in consciousness. She dared to recognize that power and wisdom within her. Hear this, out of the hundreds that were already up close to it, that were even touching it, but didn't touch it with the recognition or with the acceptance or receiving it and believing in it. Wow, that's big. This is you, right? The other hundreds were just going with their 3D will, right? The will of their own, trying to will things into being. Instead, she recognized it's not her will, but God's will. Wow, this is big. Within you, around you, working through you is that divine substance, God, that intelligent consciousness. This woman recognized that substance, right? And she touched it. She knew she was healed, right? Jesus said she was healed, right? In him we live and we move and we have our being. This is what scripture is trying to say. This is so powerful if you get this, right? So let's unpack this a little bit more. And here I'm saying it, right? The magnitude of what this miracle healing by Jesus means is a game changer if you really get it. If you really get it, that out of the hundreds that were in the crowd, right, that were up close to Jesus, even probably touching him unconsciously, hear this, on touching him unconsciously or not deliberately, where this woman actually reached out and touched his cloak. And he says, Jesus says to Peter, for sure someone touched me, for I am aware that the power has gone out of me. This is powerful. This is you consciously tapping into that power, deliberately rising in consciousness. Right? Like the woman that was healed by touching the cloak of Jesus, recognize, accept, and allow this Christ consciousness, this intelligence, this substance that fills everything around us and within us, fill and flood your entire being, or in other words, your consciousness. Fill your consciousness with that prosperity consciousness, with that Christ consciousness. Right, that's all that's required, right? Not to will it out in the 3D world, right? To wrestle those effects and look for them, right? Claim it as yours. Hear this, like she did. She claimed that. She touched Jesus. She dared to touch Jesus' cloak. Claim it as yours to fulfill every desire, solve every problem, heal every illness, right? Dissolve every fear, extinguish every doubt, and bring you unlimited prosperity in every moment and in every area of your life. That's true prosperity consciousness, right? Otherwise, even if there was an opening in your consciousness, right, and you manifest something, well, you can either lose it or not manifest something else because you don't have the consciousness. You don't have the prosperity consciousness. You've got to dwell in that higher consciousness. Then you don't have to worry about willing things into being or manifesting them. It just comes to you. It drops on your lap, right? And you can't lose anything. This way, if you had a business, no business can ever fail. No, you can never fail anything. Right? It's not about worrying about fear or worrying about losing things. You can't lose. Loss is impossible when you're in this consciousness, right? And even things that do go away, you can manifest them again because you're in that consciousness, right? You get to decide in every area of life. It truly is the truth that sets you free, right? Let's unpack this a little bit more. This power, this wisdom, this intelligence, this divine substance is your genie in a bottle. Imagine if in the house, you had in your house a genie in a bottle, and you know if you uncork that genie, that you'd never have to fear about anything, that you can have whatever your heart desires, that you could never be sick, that you could never want for anything. Imagine that's what you have in your consciousness within you. You have a genie in the bottle that you have not uncorked. Imagine this, within your consciousness, when you uncork that bottle and then let that genie out, you open yourself to the unlimited power, wisdom, intelligence to be done unto you. Hear this, right? Now fear doesn't make sense. Now doubt doesn't make sense. Now trying to will something into 3D manifestation doesn't make sense. It's all yours. The genie does it for you. Right? Let go of your needy, small, fearful 3D will and accept as your own divine will of God. Accept as your own that higher will, the will of your higher being, the will of that divine consciousness, the will of God, the will of Christ, the will of the quantum field, whatever you want to call this power and this energy, it's real and it's the only reality, right? That's what you let go of. That's what let go, let God really means. That's what letting go means. Hear this. Everyone goes, well, I really don't know what letting go means. That's what it means. Let go of that divine, that 3D will, and become one with that divine will, the will of the higher self, right? Blessed are the gentle or the meek, which they say in other versions of the Bible, for they shall inherit the earth. This is from Matthew 5:5. We've talked about this one, but what does that really mean? The gentle, that means you are, that's you, but the stronger you. That's not you as a weak person. That means you're strong. You're infinitely strong, divinely strong. You grow more gentle and tender as you open up into that knowing, right? As you open up and connect with that divine intelligence. Why? Because you're gentle, because you know you've got everything, right? The power is within you. Right? You're stronger than anything in the 3D realm. You're infinite. That's what it means. Blessed are the gentle, right? That's what it means to inherit the earth, right? Because everyone else is faking it, right? This 3D strength is puny. It's nothing compared to this gentle strength, this all-knowing strength, the strength within you, right? That's the blessed strength Wow, that's big. Let's unpack it a little bit more. This is what it says also in Scripture. It is no longer I, this is Paul, right, who in Scripture, it is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. In the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God. Hear this, right? Paul is acknowledging that it's now Christ, that higher consciousness, no longer his will or his 3D will, it's no longer his life, but that higher life. Right? And even in the flesh, he's living by the faith of the Son of God, or that Christ within you, that higher power, right? That higher consciousness, right? Your desire is God desiring it through you. Your desire is God wanting it for you through you. So don't completely give that up, right? Don't let that go. Right? Hold on to that divine will. Rise in consciousness to accept it. Rise in consciousness to allow it, to embrace it, right? It doesn't come by effort, force, hard work, or trying. None of it does. You might be able to do that in the 3D world, get things by effort, get money, people, things, influence, by effort, by hard work, but there's no guarantee that it will last. And it's fleeting. But when you're in the consciousness of it, When you're in that higher consciousness, then nothing, it's eternal, it's forever, right? Nothing is out of your reach, right? But first, seek his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. That's the promise. And so what does it mean to seek his kingdom? Seek the source. Seek the source of everything you want, as opposed to seeking these desires in the 3D world and try to manifest them physically and by force. Seek the source, and everything you want is added to you, right? Wow, that's big. So, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. What is that, your kingdom come? That's the invisible world. Consciousness in the invisible world, the visible world, the manifestations becoming one. That's the invisible becoming one with the visible. Thy kingdom come, your will be done as earth as it is in heaven. That's God's will. Right, will be done on earth. You're giving up your puny will to God, right? Give up the struggling of trying to will it to manifest. Let go to divine will or infinite intelligence. The invisible world, the consciousness, and the invisible world, the manifestations become one, right? That higher state of consciousness is heaven on earth, right? Is the state of perfect harmony between the invisible reality and the visible reality. That's what heaven on earth means. That's what heaven means. It's the harmony between your higher consciousness and your 3D reality that you're living in, right? It's the harmony between those two things. When you give up that 3D will, right? It's your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. I love this out of Luke. Who's the Father? That's unconditioned consciousness. That's God. That's infinite intelligence. It's a quantum field. It's that good pleasure of infinite intelligence to give you everything. To give you the kingdom, right? The entire thing, the whole ball of wax. All things that the Father has are mine. John 16:15. All things. That's what Jesus said. All things that the Father has are mine. All things that unconditioned consciousness can have, that has, will have, or will ever have, is mine. They're all mine. They're all yours. You just need to summon them and rise to that consciousness. Wow, that's powerful. Remember, you are the center of perfect health, perfect wealth, perfect peace, and perfect happiness, right? Infinite creative intelligence. You're the center of that infinite creative God, or God, right? You're the God center, right? When you find that center, you find infinite prosperity and divine supply. That's what really prosperity consciousness is. When you find that center, like the woman who touched Jesus' garment, when he was in that crowd, right? She found that center, right? Find infinite prosperity in divine supply. Not in the past, not in the future, but now. That's what, someone asked me, well, what does it mean to be, that everything is perfect now? That's what it means, right? You're one with that infinite supply, right? For whoever has, to him shall more be given. And whoever does not have, even what he has, shall be taken away from him. Mark 4:25. What does that mean? Have what? What are they referring to? What's Jesus referring to? To whoever has that consciousness of that infinite supply, whoever has that consciousness of that divine substance, right? More shall be given to you, right? Whoever does not have consciousness of that divine supply or infinite supply or infinite or that divine substance, what he has shall be taken away from him. That's what it's talking about. That's prosperity consciousness, right? That's what we're talking about here, guys. This is about being centered in that God consciousness, right? This is what it really means, right? This is what it really means. I am your host, Tom Caron. And this is the Be Something Wonderful studio of Higher Consciousness, where we help you level up and become the best version of yourself. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification button, like and share our videos. That's how we get our message out. Hit us up on Facebook at Be Something Wonderful, on Instagram and Twitter, Tom Caron, our website at TomCaron.com at BeSomethingWonderful.com, or write me and say hello at info@BeSomethingWonderful.com. I would love to hear from you. Until next time, have a very lovely day and a happy new year. This is Tom. See you soon.